Okay, so hello friends, today in this video I'll be sharing my experience of using this Mi Band 2 for the past 2 years, and I have already made a video regarding the features and the interface of the application, so you can check the videos out. This video will be about the experience which I faced, so yeah, let's start the video. Okay, so coming to point number one is its battery life. Now, for the past 2 years, initially the battery life was average, I would say. It used to last me around a month if I didn't connect it with my mobile phone, but now I'm getting around 40 days of battery life. Well, we're still getting the updates, and now, but if you connect your phone with your device regularly, then you will get roughly around 16 to 20 days of battery life. So yeah, the battery life is quite good, I would say. So yeah, that was the first point. Okay, so coming to point number two is that we're still getting updates of the application and the firmware. So that's a really good thing, that since it's a 2-year-old device, MI is still pushing out the updates, and yeah, the battery life has improved and we're still getting a lot of features. For example, the latest feature is that now you can reject the call. For example, let me show you. So as you can see that if you're getting a call and if you press and hold the button for 3 seconds, then it will reject the call. So coming to point number three is the wear and tear of the strap. So after using it for a year, I noticed that the glue of the strap was coming out. Well, this occurred when if you are regularly using it while you're in a pool or while you are bathing. So you need to remember that. So I ordered a similar, oops, one wobble. So yeah, I purchased this strap from Amazon, and it looks like the original one. When I purchased this was not that flexible, but now as you can see, it's quite flexible like the original one. So yeah, you need to take a note of that too. So coming to point number four is the scratches on display. So I'm not sure whether it's visible to you guys or not, but if you use it roughly, for example me, I use it 24/7, then you might get some scratches on the display. So it would be better if you buy a screen protector for the screen. Well, it's hardly visible, but if you notice in the direct light, then you might notice scratches on the display. Okay, so coming to point number five is the heart rate sensor. So from the beginning, it used to give erratic readings, and still I'm getting erratic readings. So I've received a lot of updates, but still they haven't been able to fix the bug in the heart rate sensor. So I hope that they might fix it in the near future. Okay, so these are the records, and as you can see that the record, this one is for is of 8:33 a.m. and this one is of 8:35 a.m. And as you can see that this one showed me 97 beats per minute, this one showed 90 beats per minute, and all the other records was while I was sitting idle. So as you can see that the records are quite erratic, they're not at all uniform. So yeah, this problem was since the beginning, so I won't blame that. So I hope that MI fixes it soon. And talking about the conclusion, well, the Mi Band 2 is still a very great device. Talking about the steps count, the calories burned, the distance traveled, the battery life, all are quite amazing, except the heart rate sensor, which from the beginning was not that good. And the weight is also pretty light, and while for wearing it for the past 2 years, I found my watches to be heavier. So yeah, that's a bad thing, that I'm used to the weight of the Mi Band 2. And MI is also going to launch the Mi Band 3. So if price is not an issue, then you can buy the Mi Band 2 if you want now, and then can wait, or else can wait for the Mi Band 3. So yeah, that's it for now in this video. I hope that you have liked my video. If you liked it, I would appreciate if you click the like button. If you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you have any specific questions, do not forget to comment in the comment section down below. Stay tuned and peace.